Daniel from China have made new portable system for ad games with blast positive power!
Welcome, comrades, to the Wicked Gummer on Collector. And today, we have a very new review. Yes, it's a portable system from our friends on Ed Games, or just China. So, and what comes in the package? Now, that is very simple. You can see it already. Oh, yeah. It comes with a wicked manual nobody gives a shit about. Yeah, it's got a USB cable with no power adapter. Where's my power adapter? Even my portable system of $10 has a freaking power adapter. So, Ed Games at the best. It comes with, of course, the system itself, but we're going to talk about it later. And now we're going to talk about the little box. Ooh, this looks really amazing. Look at Pac-Man. That is what I call not a happy face. This is what I call a red face. Yeah, and I'll them showing the great titles of the system. Mortal Kombat or Mortal Kombat. Ultimate Portable Game Player, with a lot of great games, a little bit of zooming, yeah. What do we have here? Arrow Flash, Ultimate Beast, Mortal Kombat 2, Mortal Kombat 3, yeah, Sonic & Knuckles, missing out Sonic 3, and more games, more China games. So, let's take a close look at the system.
And here you see the portable system itself. It's very light. And it is almost identical to the clone we reviewed earlier. Got the text Mega Drive on the back. Got an SD slot where you can put multiple extra games on it. The charger, the volume, TV out. And the on and off button. And you can also put a headphone in it. Yeah. It looks decent. The D-pad feels good. The buttons are also very responsive. And also it is a 6-button layout for games like Mortal Kombat 3, Street of Rage 3, the later Mega Drive games. So let's turn it on. And here you see the 85 games that are on it. And then I already noticed a few homebrew games. Black Sheep, what the fuck is that? Oh my god, chess, checker, yeah. It got a lot of homebrew games.
Fish tank.
Yeah.
Hey, didn't see there something very special game?
Golden Axe 3.
Yeah, a political game. The Hidden Agenda.
Oh my god. Hidden Agenda. Maze, yeah. I think almost half of the games are homebrew.
So yeah, 85 games.
My ass.
Partly China crap.
Well, at least it got the 3 Mortal Kombat games and the 3 Golden Axe. Oh, it also got Phantasy Star. I hope you can save. Otherwise, these games are useless. And it also got Shining Force, also games that are very large. Really nice, it got those good RPG games. And it got a lot of Sonic games, but Sonic I'm missing the best one, Sonic 3. Oh my goodness. Also, it doesn't have Sonic 3D Blast. Oh, probably you can hear go to the SD slot. And another few crappy games. It also got Virtua Fighter 2, that's a decent game. Well, yeah, let's test one. Sonic. Oh, you must let's start. Sonic Team Presents.
Oh, my ear are bleeding.
That could be a bit better. Speaker itself is also not very high quality.
The emulation is good.
Yeah,
it runs much better than the Chinese copy.
Yeah, it runs really smooth, but the sound is not perfect. Far from perfect.
Yeah,
Yeah. No lagging. That's nice. Now, let's test another game. Comic Zone, one of my favorite games. This one sounds a little bit better. This one sounds better than Sonic, don't you think?
Yep.
But perfect, but a lot better. Also, this game runs very smooth.
Yeah. Seeing this, feeling that the game is in turbo mode, but it can be moved.
Yeah, but I think those are the Genesis versions, and those are a little bit faster than the PAL versions. But I don't find that very annoying. It's better that it is a little bit faster and very slow, in my opinion. Yeah, let's test another game. Golden Axe. I'm missing some games, like Street of Rage.
Mm-hmm.
That's really a shame. It got all the three Mortal Kombat and Golden Axe, but not Street of Rage. Oh.
Something I had to do the first time. Getting the button. Yeah, emulation of the games was good.
Yeah, the sound also on this game is not really bad. But I prefer to use a headphone jack on it, because the speaker isn't the greatest. Oh. Yeah. Now, let's test some games on the SD card. We put a few games on it. He first must search for it. Okay.
Street of Rage.
Yeah.
Two? Yep.
It's below. It must first load the game. That's a shame.
No instant load.
Nope.
It's just like a cheap EverDrive. You need to load up into the system. Yeah. System ROM, RAM, what do you call it? So it's totally different.
Yeah.
But it's not smooth.
Yeah, it runs smooth, but the sound isn't the greatest. Okay, let's try another game. Let's try Castlevania. That's a game a lot of emulator systems have problems with. I'm very curious if it works. Love this game. It works. That's very good. Also, the sound isn't that bad. That's pretty cool. You can put a game on the SD card.
Yeah, that's true. I think that is the big plus of this handheld.
Yeah.
Most Chinese handhelds have the main problem with building games, and that's it. And let's be honest, 85 games. Okay, it's fun to have many games, but a lot of hokey crappy games.
I think there are around 45 real Genesis Mega Drive games and 40 homebrew games on it. So it's really good that you can add more games on it. But yeah, this is very good. Now, what is my conclusion about this system? Well, I tried a few other games, and there are some games, some good games, like The Lion King from Disney, and NBA Jam TE, and one of the most important games, Contra, that don't work on it, or don't work fine on it. So it's not 100% compatible with all Mega Drive Genesis games. That's really a shame. And it also can't save on the SD card. The games that are on it, like Phantasy Star and Shining Force, those games you can save on it, but the extra games you can you put on the SD card, there's no save function. So that's really a downside of the system. Besides that, yeah, it got a nice LCD screen, and the buttons feel fine. Not great, but good enough to play it. Yeah, for the price, I think it's a little bit too expensive for what you can get, and it's really annoying you only get one cable with no power supply on it, and also no TV out. So yeah, if I must give it a number, I think I give it a 6 out of 10. I don't know what you think about it.
Yep, I agree.
It's a nice thing to have for your collection, really, if you are a Sega fan, but nothing more than that. And yeah, the emulation of the sound could also be much better. Soon we will make a review of the Sega Flashback system, and they say the sound has been improved a lot, so... We are very curious about that. Thank you for watching. And till next time. Bye bye.
Bye.
I want to thank you. I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Oh, and you can follow me on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram.